So over the weekend, in about an hour, I made this app using a tool called FlutterFlow. Now that might sound like I'm making this to brag, but I'm not. I just was blown away myself at how easy this was to use. I really believe that tools like this are the future of design, and people can talk all they want about how generative AI is used for design, but I think the real power of new technologies is bringing design and code closer together. Over the last year, we saw a design tool called Framer completely pivot to making websites where with one click, you could just publish them and you'd have a website live and there was no coding involved. So I think tools like this are gonna become more and more common. So stick around and I'll show you how I made this app. But first, let me just say, hey, I'm Parvin. I'm a designer from London and I make videos on how to become a better designer. If that sounds like something that interests you, please do hit subscribe below so you don't miss any more of my videos. This app is super simple. It's a timer to record Crazy 8, and you can see it's just a big start button. When I press that, it starts counting down a minute, and it starts counting down from 8 minutes at the same time. And as I progress through each idea of a Crazy 8, the idea count goes up and it plays a little sound. So, how did I have this idea? Well, last week I was hanging out with my friend Laura. She's the UK's top freelance UX designer, and you can watch an interview I did with her here. And she was telling me about some contracting work she does for a design sprint company. They're called Design Sprint X, and I looked them up and I found out that one of their funnels for acquiring more customers is they have a Crazy 8 timer app. Unfortunately, the app was only for iPhones and I'm an Android user, so I couldn't install it, but I thought, hey, this feels like such a cool, simple app, it might be fun to design it. So while I had a bit of downtime on the weekend, I started designing it. So this was my design process. So the first thing I did was jump into Whimsical. Now, I know loads of people like drawing sketches by hand, and I do too, but I think Whimsical is just the perfect, perfect low fidelity ideation platform. And what I mean by those long words, low fidelity ideation, is that you can very quickly click on the canvas and add frames. There's loads of elements, so you can just get your buttons, change it between links and fills. And what's cool about this is that you can't add too much detail. You can align things, you can group them, and you've got some like block fonts and lorem ipsum, but you can't get too detailed with the colors. And in fact, you only get about 8 colors to choose from. So I made these 2 simple screens. The first one was just a start button with some instructions and this nice little grid to show you how to fold the paper up. And then this in the middle of the timer page. So here, the only thing you can do is cancel to stop the timer, which gives you a little dialogue. And otherwise, the time just ticks down, so you see your remaining time for the current idea, nice and big, and then time elapsed overall and which current sketch you're on. And that's also shown visually with this indicator of how you're moving through the paper. I should say also at this point, if you don't know what Crazy 8s are, Crazy 8 is an ideation process. It comes from the sprint book, and it's just a way to come up with ideas really, really rapidly in 8 minutes. So then I moved into FlutterFlow. So I did take this into Figma and played around with making the colors a bit nicer, but I really wanted to see if I could just make this idea in FlutterFlow straight away. So FlutterFlow, it looks super confusing, but the way it works is this. You've got your pages over here, and these are like the pages of the app. And so we just needed 2 pages, a home page and a timer page. And so I made this layout, a simplified version. I was thinking MVP, MVP, get rid of the grid of pages for now and just have a big start button. And you can see here in the layers panel that the way this works is columns and rows. So we've got a column here, and then those are wrapped in a column overall. And we've got alignment options here. So it's kind of similar to auto layout in Figma, if you've used that. It's kind of similar to Flexbox. It's more close to maybe Swift UI stacks, if you know what those are. But I'm absolutely confident if you play around with it, you'll figure it out. It's just rows and columns and different ways of wrapping elements. So then I added in some custom fonts from Google Fonts, which come preloaded. Added another page for the timer. And here they give you a timer element. So that was easy. I just had a countdown timer, which shows minutes and seconds instead of having hours and milliseconds, and how much time to put on and how often the page should update. And I did that again for a long timer here, which is the one which counts down from 8 minutes overall, so you know where you are in the whole overall time. And then I linked it all up with actions. Now the action editor is a bit hidden, but it's over here. So if we click under scaffolding for homepage, this shows the properties for the homepage, and then we can go into an action editor. So action flow editor, if I click on the start button, find that same tab here, and you can see I've defined an action for on tap navigate to a page, but we can also do that in this bigger action flow. So this is very simple. It's kind of like adding prototyping actions. So actions, conditionals. Again, if you've done any Figma prototyping, this will be really familiar to you. And I've actually made a video on using state in Figma prototypes using Figma variables. So go check that out if you're new to prototyping in Figma. But if you want to have a go at FlutterFlow, I'm so confident that you'll be able to get this straight away. So over on my timer page, the actions happen on page load. So if I open up my action flow editor, we can see on page load is the trigger. And the two actions are starting the timer and starting the other timer. So we start both of the timers when we get to this page. Then what about when each timer completes? So if I look at the smaller timer, look at the action flow editor, when this minute finishes, I want it to play a sound. I want it to update the app state, which I'll talk about in a second, and then I want it to restart itself. And the way it restarts itself is in two steps. Firstly, it resets the timer, so it goes back up to a minute, and then it does start. Now, that thing about app state that I mentioned, what was that about? Well, you might have noticed here for current idea, instead of just text, we've got three text items wrapped in a row, and the first one says square brackets count. And that's because this text object is linked to a variable. So instead of just typing in text up here, where we could type in a number, I've pressed this settings toggle and linked it to a variable, which in this case is the app state count. App state again lives in a bit of a hidden place. It lives on this left-hand menu called app values. And if you click into that, you can add new variables. So these are just variables that you need across the app. You can also put constants in here. And if you need variables just for a single page, there's a place for page variables as well. But here I thought I'd do this as an app state variable. It's just called count. The default value is 1. It's not persisted. So if you close the app and reopen it, it resets. And this is all we use to keep track of when we've hit 8 counts. And then we stop the timer repeating after more than 8, because that's what we're trying to do in Crazy 8s. So I won't talk through the final bits on long timer, because I just wanted to make this really short video. But mostly what I wanted to say is I think you should go and try this. FlutterFlow just announced a Series A. I think they've raised about 25 million. So they're not going anywhere. It's backed by people from Google and the code export is amazing. You can export Flutter code. You can export APKs, which you can upload to the Google Play Store. You can also just upload straight to the iOS App Store and the Google Play Store together. So there's no fiddling around with environments and setting up coding things, but that option is there if you want it, because we're just making code right now. We're just making code in a really easy to use editor. So I think this is the future for designers, and I really recommend you go give it a go. I'm going to finish off this app by adding a bit more color and maybe adding that little widget at the bottom, trying to make that work. And I'll post below if it's available to download and install. I really hope I can get this finished up, but I just wanted to make a quick video about this. I've left some links in the description with some more helpful resources for getting started with FlutterFlow, which I found really useful. But to be honest, the best way is to just jump in. If you're using Figma or you're using other design tools, I promise you, you'll be able to use this and you'll be making real apps in absolutely no time. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this, please do let me know by leaving a comment below or hitting the like button. It really helps me out as I'm trying to grow this channel. If you have ideas for more videos or more tutorials or things you want to see on this channel, just let me know and I'll be sure to get to them. Thank you so much again and see you on the next one.